Hey, this is Randy from Funeral Funds of America, and in this video, we are going to talk about the actual cost for $5,000 worth of burial, cremation, final expense, life insurance, or funeral funds for a 70-year-old female. Now, keep in mind, you can go to any page on our website at funeralfunds.com. Just click the state, click the coverage, put your birthday in, and you'll be able to see the actual quota that we use and get pricing from all the different insurance companies. We make that available to you. So feel free to do that. Also, we have a YouTube link, funeralfunds.com/YouTube, where you can log on and get special discounts for our YouTube viewers. So first thing you want to ask yourself when looking for $5,000 for a 70-year-old female is $5,000 going to be enough for what you need? That's a pretty important one to get right. So if you're looking at a burial, or no, let's start with cremation. If you're looking at a cremation, the average cost of a cremation in the United States is between $1,000 to $2,000. Now, that's if you just come home in a cardboard box or an urn. So nothing fancy. Now, if you're going to have some sort of celebration of life ceremony or remembrance ceremony, anything like that, any get together with the family, that's probably going to get up to $3,500 to $4,500. So $5,000 would definitely be enough to take care of things. But we would generally say $5,000, you know, if you were just doing the cremation, coming home in a cardboard box or an urn, because you're 70 years old. We're hoping you get to 75 and 80 and 85. And we want to make sure that there's some extra money in there to allow for inflation as time goes on. Now, if you're looking for some sort of ceremony or service, then we'd probably recommend you look like maybe at $7,000 to $10,000, probably more the lower range, or $7,500 would probably be the happy medium. At least take a look at that. Now, if you're looking at a burial and you're looking at a $5,000 policy, boy, that's not probably going to go over very well at the funeral home, because the average cost of a funeral right now in the United States is right around $10,000. Now, $10,000, that's not going to be anything fancy. So just understand that, you know, pretty much any funeral home you walk into at the time of this video, if you've got a $10,000 check, they'll work with you. It's not going to be anything fancy, I can guarantee you that. But I just can't imagine that they would let that money walk away down the street to a competitor. But the kind of the biggest concern is, you know, that will pay for it right now. But again, what if you are blessed to live to 75 or 80 or 85? Then, you know, what it costs today will not cover what it costs later. But a couple thoughts on this one. Number one, if your budget's tight, just get the $10,000. That takes care of your most immediate needs right now. You can always save up a little extra money on the side as kind of time goes on. Or we can just help you get more coverage. We can add on another $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, whatever it would be at some point in the future to kind of get that value up if needed when prices do go up. You're always better having something versus not having something. So we always recommend you get first day coverage. And that's what we specialize here at funeralfunds.com. We specialize in first day coverage or benefits with low cost same day approvals. And we really recommend you avoid the 2-year waiting period policy. So first year coverage means that, you know, if you got your policy today and God forbid you died tomorrow, the insurance company would have to pay the money. And a lot of times people go, well, you know, there's health questions with that first day coverage. Yeah, you're right. There is health questions, but we work with enough different insurance companies and they all have kind of special niches where they look at certain health conditions more favorably than the other. So we're pretty good. 90-95% average first day coverage approval rate. So just don't worry about that. Really, the only reason you wouldn't qualify for first day coverage is if you had really significant health issues going on, maybe a terminal illness where you're going to pass away in the next 12 months, or, you know, dementia or dialysis, or you're in a hospital or a nursing home. Another thing that happens once in a while, far too frequently, unfortunately, is that people will call us up and say, hey, we had a family member pass away this last week. The body's down at the funeral home and they didn't have insurance and we don't have any money. So we need to get this insurance right away because the funeral home's demanding money and we got to get the money so we can get, you know, our family member buried. And we have to tell those people, unfortunately, that there's no insurance company in the United States that will offer an insurance policy on somebody who's already died. And it's really sad because, you know, people are just really struggling and hurting and kind of grasping for straws. But there's no product out there once somebody's died that's going to pay this for you. So kind of the lesson to be learned is take care of this before you need it. You're always better off having some insurance versus no insurance. Now, 2-year waiting periods. Let's look at one company out there. Colonial Penn's probably the most popular, you know, 2-year waiting period company, just because they advertise so much. But just understand their $9.95 plan. You know, boy, TV commercials all over. Seems like every 10 minutes on the TV, $9.95. And a lot of people just, you know, like 7-year-old females go, oh, that's going to be terrific for $9.95. I'm going to be able to get $20, $30, $40, $50,000 worth of insurance. And nothing could be further from the truth, my friends. Nothing, 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 nothing. So Colonial Penn, $9.95 is a 2-year waiting period. Mutual of Omaha, their United of Omaha product is a 2-year waiting period. AIG, Gerber, those are all 2-year waiting periods. There's plenty more out there. And those types of insurance companies have done a fairly good job of kind of advertising and making people think that the only type of burial, cremation, final expense, life insurance, funeral funds for people out there is ones with 2-year waiting periods. And nothing could be further from the truth. We help people with first day coverage all day long. Let's take a look at Colonial Penn here. So they Colonial Penn's got their $9.95 plan. And let's take a look. We've got a female age 70 right here. And what's, you know, we're looking at $5,000 for this video, but I always like to show what one unit actually buys. So for $9.95, one unit. And this is very rare. I will tell you, this is very rare, freakishly rare, that Colonial Penn, when you put $9.95, it comes up with an even number. A lot of times it's like an $872 or $1,021, just really odd numbers. For the most part, you can't buy even amounts of coverage through Colonial Penn's $9.95 because it just kind of, you end up with coverage amounts that are kind of wackadoodle numbers, whereas most other insurance all other insurance companies out there, for the most part, you can say, hey, I want $5,000, I want $10,000, I want $6,000, I want $4,000. With Colonial Penn, you see some interesting numbers, and we may see that when we kind of get up a few more units here. But, you know, so $9.95 for a 7-year-old female is only going to get $1,000. Now, that's not even enough to pay for a burial or a cremation. Remember, cremations are $1,000 to $2,000. So on average, between $1,400 to $1,600. $1,000 isn't even going to cut the mustard, as they say. And keep this in mind, too. It's $1,000, but it's not paying for the first 2 years. So, you know, 2 years from now, $1,000 is going to be worth less than it is today due to inflation. So, you know, that $9.95 kind of sounds kind of sexy once in a while. But it's kind of disappointing, you know, to a lot of folks when they see that that's all the coverage they get. It's really brilliant marketing, to be honest. I know it gets Colonial Penn a lot of phone calls and a lot of people submitting their emails and phone numbers and full info and birthday and all that stuff. But if you look online, there's an awful lot of complaints. Just more about kind of people thinking they can get more coverage. And Colonial Penn's very clear on the website, but you've got to give your info to find out how little coverage it is. Just be aware of that. Let's see if we can figure out what it takes to get $5,000. We got to play around with the funky units. I'm going to guess since one unit is $1,000, we're going to look at right around 5 units. There you go. I tell you what, this is just very odd. It's a 70-year-old female that's all even numbers. If you look at our other videos in the series, which will be in the comment section below, you'll see that the numbers are very much different. This is pretty unique. That's actually $5,000, but that'd be $49.75, roughly $50. I'm just going to round the numbers up. So let's go look at a first day coverage company on our quarter and see if there's any price savings to be had by going with first day coverage. So we've got $5,000 here, 70-year-old female. I'm going to scroll down. We're going to hit the quote button. I'm going to go back here. Remember, this is, I'm going to round the numbers up, easy math, $50 for $5,000. And we go down here, and would you look at that? So Trinity Life Insurance Company we work with, terrific company. We love them. Great prices, great customer service, everything. Level. So simplified issue level. That level means first day coverage. Okay. So $27.30. So remember, Colonial Penn's roughly $50. I'm just rounding up. So the Colonial Penn is almost 200% more. Almost, just a little bit under, but almost 200% more. And you've got to go through a 2-year waiting period. You have to suffer through a 2-year waiting period, putting your family at risk, to be perfectly honest, because if you can get first day coverage, the policy will pay out in the first 2 years, no matter what kind of death. So just be smart shoppers out there, and, you know, just probably go with a company that you actually trust. And, you know, at Funeral Funds of America, we're trying to be that company that you trust. And we just got this transparency so that you can see what's going on. Let's look at a couple other insurance companies here. So try to find somebody that advertises a lot. Okay, here's a company, Lincoln Heritage. Fine company, level coverage. But when you look at their pricing, it's like $39. They're almost $40. And you go, well, why is it higher? Well, they've got a program where, you know, when somebody passes away, they'll call 2 or 3 funeral homes and, you know, kind of get the best pricing. They do a couple other things, but you end up paying for it over time in premiums, because we're just going to round it up. Say it's $40. And you come down here and this is 27. So that'd be roughly, I'm going to go easy math, roughly $12 a month. So 12 times 12 is $144 a year. You're paying more. If a 70-year-old female lives another 10 years, that's going to be $1,440 roughly more that they pay over the period of 10 years. Remember, you're going to pay that higher premium the rest of your life. So, you know, if Lincoln Heritage makes 2 or 3 phone calls, does a couple things for $1,440, that's pretty good pay for them. But, you know, you've got to ask yourself, is it worth paying that much extra? And if you live another 20 years, that's 2,880 more. So we would rather see you spend that money on your family and your loved ones while you're alive rather than give that to an insurance company. Now, what we do is we provide a free funeral and estate planning guide where you can fill all your information out, what you want done, where you want to go, assets, everything. And you just actually keep that with your policy, your insurance policy. And when you pass away, all that information's there. And your family will be blessed. They will know that you were loving and thinking about them and took care of this for them so that when they're going through a very difficult time, they don't have to worry about that. And it saves you money. So just an FYI. So keep in mind, going back to our website here, you can always just fill in a quote here on our page. You can call our toll-free number, 888-862-9456. We're licensed in all 50 states. And whether you have an existing insurance policy that you just want to add money to, or you add insurance, or you have a policy that you want to shop around and see if you can get better pricing, or you just need a brand new policy, just let us know. Reach out. We're happy to help you out with that. No pressure. If you just want information, we're cool with that. So reach out to us. We look forward to the day when we are able to meet and talk with you. And until that day comes, you take care. You stay safe. Bye-bye.